This is the continuation of 10th page. This is the Banshan boiler. In here we can see the distribution header in left side bottom. Ready and evaporator. Boiler feed water pump is inlet in the right side of the top of the boiler. This is coming to the economizer. Then it is going to the distribution header of left side bottom, and it is going to the radiant evaporator in horizontally. Then it is going to the transition zone. After this is going to the superheater. In transition zone, the water is converted to the converting into steam. After the steam, it is going to superheater. After the superheater, it is going to the superheater steam outlet. In top of the boiler, it is the air heater is available. Air in and air out is also available. The flue gas is traveling as vertical from the bottom to the top. The next question, it is the Banshan boiler. The next question, sometimes, 1 minute, Banshan boilers, again I am auxiliaries are air heater, economizer, transition zone, superheater, radiant evaporator in the bottom. So the next question, sometimes special features of boilers are used to classify them. How is this done? Answer is, depending upon the placement and firing operations of burners, boilers may be classified as differential fire type, tangential fire type. Similarly, there is anthra-tube boiler which is completely self-contained anthracite burning unit. Different variations exist, such as tube-in-tube boiler, top fire boiler, and so on. There are also dual circulation boiler with gas circulation, pressurized and supercharged boilers. The next question, how are boilers generally categorized? Answer, they may be categorized into four general types: steel boiler, cast iron boilers, special design boiler, nuclear power boilers. In steel boilers, fire tube boiler, water tube boiler, and shell type boiler. Water tube boilers may be further subdivided into horizontal straight tube boiler, bent tube boiler. Bent tube boiler, natural circulation type, and forced circulation type. The next question, what are the inherent advantages of horizontal straight tube boilers if the tube sizes are small? Answer is, tube replacement is easier in horizontal straight tube boilers. Tube replacement is easier, draft is loss is low. Better end-to-end visible through tubes before after cleaning. Greater accessibility to all components for inspection and cleaning. Low head room. The next question, smaller straight tube horizontal boilers are associated with certain advantages. What are the answer of advantages for advantages? First one, access to internal components uses more time and labor. Inadequacy in design adds to grievance of the operators. Second one, because of relatively low circulation rates and poor circulatory distribution, the steam generation rate is sharply impaired. Third one, if steaming rate is raised, the separation of steam from water in the steam drum becomes inadequate because the limited surface area available for disengagement. In here, this is the sulzer boiler. In sulzer boiler also have auxiliaries of evaporator, transition zone, superheater, economizer, and air heater. In here, the first water is inlet from the boiler feed water. It is in the right side of the diagram. in boiler feed water super heater. From the boiler super boiler feed water super heater, it is going to the economizer. After that, distribution header. Through the distribution header, it is going to the evaporator. In evaporator, it has transition zone that water converts into the steam in that area. Then it is going to the steam separator. In here, the water is again going to the boiler feed water, and the separate from the separator, the steam is going to the super heater, and it goes super heater steam header. Blowdown is available in the preheater, boiler feed water preheater, in the bottom side of the right side of the diagram. Flue gas is going horizontally from the evaporator to the air heater. This is the Sulzer boiler. Low mount boiler is also, the flue gas is transferred as vertically. In here also, the feed water inlet is right side top of the boiler. This is going to the economizer, and after the economizer, it is going to the steam and water drum. From this, the drum separates the steam. The steam is going to the superheater and also the secondary evaporator. Steam is going to the superheater. From the drum, the water is going to the boiler feed water circulation pump. From the pump, it is going to the primary evaporator. After that, secondary evaporator, then it is again circulated to the boiler. This is the low mount boiler. In lay floor boiler also, we can see the boiler feed water pump inlet in the right side of the diagram. It is going to the economizer. After the, it is going to the aspirator. Then the mud drum, sludge is going to the collect in mud drum. Blowdown is available in lay flow boiler. After the water is coming from the steam and water drum to the mud drum, and spray is available in top of the boiler drum. The distribution header is also available in the left side of the diagram boiler. It is going to the radiant superheater. After that, it is going to convective superheater. So after that, it is going to superheater steam. In lay flow boiler, the mud drum is available in extra. We can see the air heater on the top of the boiler. It is also, flue gas is transmission from bottom of the boiler to the top of the boiler vertically. Next question. Briefly describe the horizontal straight tube boiler. Answer. These boilers are made up of banks of straight tube boilers, straight tubes laid out in a staggered arrangement at an angle 5 degree to 15 degree to the horizontal, which are expanded into headers at the ends. The tubes are 75 to 100 mm in diameter, with the length not exceeding 600 cm. Smaller diameter tubes are selected when greater tube spacing is required to meet steam demand at higher pressure, providing flat surfaces. For this tube convection, the header may be a box or sectional type connecting to the drum by means of circulating tube downtakes and uptakes. The drum may be of the longitudinal or brass type. This boiler may be oil, gas, coal, bagasse or wood fired. Pulverized coal firing can also be incorporated. When the boiler is fired, steam and water rise along the inclined tubes to the front headers and then pass to the drum through circulation boiler tubes uptakes. The water then circulates down to the downtakes to the rear header and finally to the tubes to complete the cycle. The next question. Why are the tubes in horizontal straight tubes boilers inclined at the angle of 5 to 15 degree to the horizontal? Answer. To ensure boiler circulation. The question. Briefly describe the bent tube boiler. These multi-drum water tube boilers fitted with 2-3 of drum, 4 drums, and usually having one lower drum called mud drum that serves as a blowdown for removal of sludge and concentrated of salts. The remaining drums placed on the top of the boiler are called steam and water drums. The tubes may be inclined or vertical, arranged in banks or forming water walls bagged with furnace wall refractories. Buffers are placed in the gas bath to ensure even heating of water tubes. The drums are protected from the radiant heat of fire. The mode of steam water circulation is shown in figure. The boiler lends themselves to wide range of fuel burning. They can be fired with oil, gas, coal, bagasse and wood. For higher capacity of steam generation, 45 ton per hour, pulverized coal or crushed coal, cyclone furnace firing is adopted. Bent tube boilers have high steam generation rate and quick to respond to fluctuating loads. Thank you. Next video, we will see the diagram. And this is the page number of 13.